everyone, it's Jen Massia from The Clean Fitness. I wanted to once again do another boot camp reboot. Since I wasn't able to post this on YouTube, I can post this one because I will have no music. So it's a pretty simple format. We're gonna be doing two exercises back to back, 50 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. It'll be 4 minute hit circuit, and then we're gonna do some challenge moves, which is always gonna be some sort of push up and some sort of kettlebell swing. If you don't have a kettlebell, you can use a dumbbell. And actually for this whole workout, you can use just dumbbells. I am, however, going to use my bag for a few of the leg moves. So we're just gonna go ahead and start. We're gonna start with a Tabata warm up, and we're going to do bear hold kick throughs, alternating with a step up reverse lunge switch, 4 minutes to get upper and lower body warmed up. We're gonna go in 10 seconds with that bear hold. So remember, you're in that tabletop, hovering your knees in that tabletop position and just kicking through. Kicking through, I'm just gonna do a little toe tap. So rotating, focusing on your core, focusing a little bit, you're gonna get shoulders. Trying your best to keep your knees just hovering. Three. Step up, reverse lunge switch. Make sure my coffee doesn't spill. Doesn't matter what you start with, but I'll start with my right. Reverse lunge, jump switch. Trying to get deep in those lunges. Get range of motion. Ready for your leg moves that are coming up. Pressing up with the heel. We will be doing these later with weights. All right, bear hold with a kick through. So try and keep your head in good alignment, rotating. Stepping up is the same one that's reversing back. Woo. Lost a little balance there. This is normal. Jump switch. All right, we're halfway there. 2 more minutes of our warm up. 5 seconds. Control movement. Keep that core tight. Starting with my right again. Last time through, and hopefully you'll be fully warmed up. Going in 3 seconds. Shoulders right above the hands. These are just slightly hovering. 3 seconds. All right, left leg, and then we'll start. We got 6 of these sets coming up. I believe I did this workout in April. Get something to drink and and get ready for your first set. So two exercises back to back, 50 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. We'll do that twice through, and then we're gonna do 10 push-ups and 15 kettlebell swings. So I will use my 65 for the swings when we get there. So chest press, I'll do 30s with the leg raise, and then I'm gonna do reverse lunge static. I'll use 25s for that. I'll stick to the same leg. So anytime I'm doing single leg moves, I'm gonna stick to the same leg for the full 50 to really fire it up. These are 4 minute sets, so they'll go pretty quick. All right, so we're starting in 5 seconds with chest press, leg raise. I'll just move back just to make sure I don't hit my elevation. Starting in 5 seconds. 3, 2. All right, so I like timed moves because you just focus on the movement, not think about counting reps. Right now, I need to focus on my chest. You're getting some shoulders too, and triceps, but more chest, and then I'm getting lower abs. So obviously with this move, when you add the lower ab, you can't go as heavy as you normally would with a regular chest press. So breathe through, focus. I'll do my right leg this round. I'll do left, so it's reverse into a static lunge. So focus on depth. Feet together. Reverse. And static. Keep that core tight. Pressing up with that front heel. Another hot day. It's been really, really hot these past couple days. It's brutal. It's good to get your workout done early if you're outside. This is the heat. 8 seconds. And then we'll go back to the chest. Press, leg raise. So I can feel my left leg firing up. Last time. Use those 10 seconds to set up. Can't get in time, you can't get down in time, don't rush it to the point where you could hurt yourself. Safety first. The nice thing about this is you're only doing everything twice. Mentally easy, right? Still challenging. Use those lower abs. I like to work on the eccentric to the lowering portion. Lose focus when you're doing something for this long. All right, we're done with those. Right leg's gonna be stable. Left is going back. So the right's gonna work. Sweat's starting, which isn't too hard in this heat. Feel that left, oh, I'm sorry, right glute working. 20 seconds. Then we got some push-ups and swings. Keep that core tight. Got 15 swings after 10, just standard push-ups. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Popping it up for my 15. 15 swings. And I have my heavier bell for that. Remember hinging, squeezing glutes, coming forward. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, five, four, last three, two, and one. All right, recover. We're gonna move on to our next set. So we're gonna do a bicep curl into a press. So curl, Arnold press for your first exercise. Second exercise, I am gonna use my bag because I'm doing a squat with the bag and then going into a good morning. And I definitely prefer just doing good mornings back loaded. You can definitely do a front loaded with the dumbbell if you want, or you can put the dumbbell behind your back when you do your good morning. I like the bag. And this one's set up at 45 pounds, all right? Once again, same format. 50 seconds on, 10 seconds rest. I'm gonna use, I'll use 15s for my bicep curl to press. Going in 5 seconds. Three, the curl, and press. So obviously, shoulders aren't getting as heavy as I normally can. I'd like something actually in between a 15 and a 20. Just wanna make sure I'm not rocking and I'm using my muscles. Sometimes people go too heavy and they start rocking their body and the muscles don't get fully engaged and worked when you're doing that. 20 seconds, so squeeze the biceps and then press those shoulders. And you can always go heavy for the first couple of reps if you need to, and then drop if you want. 7 seconds. I'm gonna grab my bag. Like I said, you can use dumbbells for this if you wish. This is great. I don't like handles in my back. So starting with a squat. So just alternating between the two movements. Squat, get that nice hinge, hip movement for the good morning. Make sure your bag's not tugging at your hair like mine is. Squeeze those glutes, sit back in that squat. Muscles that you're using, mind-muscle connection, very important. 4 seconds. Back to my curl and press. Just pulling it up and pressing it up. Squeeze. Workout. Probably faster than when I do it in a class. 30 seconds. Squeeze. Press. 22 seconds. Keeping that core tight. 10 seconds. Four. Get sweat in my eyes. Alternating that squat with the good morning. Last 50 seconds. Please fly. 4 minutes flies. To our bonus round. So we have 10 wide push-ups and we have 15 overhead swings. So for the overhead swing, I'm going to go lighter. So obviously if you don't have variety of kettlebells, I'm going to use a 40 for the overhead. Use a dumbbell for this to make it more like a slam. Whatever works for you. I'm going to do wide push-ups, so wider than standard for 10. Rush through these. 8, 9, 10, 15 overhead. Might have to come out a little bit just because of my ceiling, my garage. Here we go. So sticking point, 1, 2, 3. Seven more. 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Gently put it down. And we're gonna get ready for our next hit. We got Manmakers. I'll use 25s for the Manmakers. And then we have front lunge. I think I'm trying to use the same weights for both of these. So front lunge into a single leg deadlift and reverse lunge. So three moves in one, focusing on one leg the whole time. I'll use 25s for that. Whew. How's my heart rate here? Quickly. Alright, here we go. Manmakers. I'll walk you through these if you don't know these. Going in a plank. Do a push-up. Row. Push-up. Row. I like to wide stance my feet. Pop it in. Clean. And press. There. All right. I'm gonna make sure I have room here, so I'll start with my left grounded. So you're gonna front lunge, single leg down left, reverse. Core needs to be tight for these. Thank you. 13 seconds. And we got Manmakers again. All right, resting my grip. Oh, one more time through, guys. Going in 3 seconds. I'm actually gonna do everything on the left, starting on the left. Row. So I'm rowing this time, just to be fair. Especially if you're going heavy, if you're going lighter. Alright, now my right will be grounded, my left's gonna move. Going in 3 seconds. You have to tap, it's okay. But all that weight, majority of it, should be on the right. Another challenge round. We got 10 tricep push-ups and 15 single arm. So 15 on each leg. I'm sorry, arm. I'm gonna use my 40s for that, starting with our 10 triceps. Close to the body. One, two, three, four, five, six. You should feel this in the triceps. Seven, eight, nine. Chest to the ground. Ten. Single arm. Switching on the 15th rep. I just want to make sure I'm not using 50s. All right, standing back, hinging to grab the weight. 15 on each. One, two, hinging. Three, four, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, two, three, four, and switch. 15 more. One, two, three, four, seven, eight, nine. Keep that core tight. 10. Protect your back. One, two, three. Squeeze the glutes. Four, and five. All right. Round three done. Moving on to round four. Two new moves. So we have roll back with a slam and step ups with reverse lunges. So sticking to the same leg the whole time. So I'll use 25s for the step ups. I'm gonna use a 35 for the roll back. Starting with that roll back, coming up. Slamming once again, a lot of back. So, you know, protect it, keep the core tight, do your best. Starting in 5 seconds. We to your chest. Coming down. Doing like a pullover. I guess it's more like a get up. Pressing it up. And slam to chest. Start with my left leg stepping up. Just I seem to be doing left first. Step up. Left also comes back into that reverse. Messing up with that heel. There. Ten seconds. 3 seconds. All right, roll back slam for the last time. Squeeze the glutes and slam it. Got about 15 seconds. Reverse, step up into reverse. I'm gonna do right, stepping up this round. So 10 decline push-ups and 10 reset swings. Obviously I need my elevation for the decline. Feet are up. Can't do decline, just do regular standard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, resets. I'm gonna try and use my 65. Stepping back. Just protect your back on these. So if it's too much, just do regular swings. 15 total. Ooh. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, five more. Two. Last one. And one. Oh, recover. Those are always hard and challenging. Walk it off. All right, we're moving on to our fifth one. So we got single arm. Uneven or elevated, I guess it's uneven, push up with a snatch. So I'm going to alternate on those, and then I got Bulgarians, so I need my elevation for that as well. Whew. This swing's got my heart up. A little bit of coffee, but we're busting through this workout pretty quickly. Switching size to side on that, and then 25s. I'm turning to 25s. I want to focus on my range if I can. Starting in 5 seconds. One weight on the bell. Push up, tuck your feet in, and snatch. Bring it to the other side. Power it up. Started on my right this round. I'll start on my left the next round. Right, Bulgarians. I'm gonna do my left foot forward. Focus, because you don't want to lose balance. All right, back to those push-ups with a snatch. I'm going to start on my left. Seconds. Got about 15. Bulgarians, right will be forward. there, guys. We're only gonna have one more of these left. And then a nice little bonus. We have 10 pike push-ups and a squat swing. So I'm gonna use 40s for my squat swing. Pike some tissues and body weight. So in that V position, you want your body to come down like this on an angle, so you're working with shoulders. Whew. My heart rate is up, 165. I'm gonna try and let it go down a little bit. So when you position for the pike, your hands are down, you're in a V position with your body, and your head kind of goes into that diagonal. You kind of make a diamond with your hands and your head, kind of like what you do with a kettlebell swing, making that like diamond. Or I guess really it's a triangle. All right, here we go. Okay, so in your V, if you want to make it hard, you can elevate your feet and come down. One, two, three. We got squat swings, 40s. So swing the squat is one rep. So swinging and then squat swing. Unless you want to just do all squat swings, it's up to you, I guess. I'm going to alternate. One, two, three, four. Five more. One, two, three. Use your dumbbell for this. Four, five. I've noticed I didn't touch my 50. So I guess you could use heavy and light because I'll use my 40 for the last round. All right. Last round. Got the elevation needed. Here's my bag. So I'm gonna do a single leg as best as I can with the bag on my back. Coming up, front lunge. That's the second exercise. So I'll focus on one leg the whole time on that one. And then I'm gonna do an L raise, lighter weights. So coming up and making an L. I was gonna use 12s, but I think right now I'm gonna use 10s with my shoulders. Press it, you can go heavy. Lateral raises, front raises, that sort of thing. It's okay to go light and more reps. So, in my bag, my 10s. We'll see how the 10 goes. They're too light. Maybe I'll go up for the second round, we'll see. Okay. Starting in 5 seconds. Is that right? I don't want to be swinging, you know? Like, even 10s, I think, actually, are going to be challenging for 50 seconds. Keep that core tight. And during your 10-second rest, you got to quickly get that bag. Or if you're using a dumbbell, you can use a dumbbell. I guess I could use a dumbbell. Try the bag for a little more challenge. Trying my best not to tap that elevated foot. 10 seconds. I'm glad I didn't grab 12s. All back is out of the back is use the bars. Pressing up with the foot that's grounded. We're getting so close, especially to this hip portion. Firing up that left leg. Slow and controlled. Now raise. Whew. About 30 seconds. Left. So getting that lateral and front raise, but alternating. So hitting anterior delt and medial delt. 8 seconds. Last three. All right, right foot's gonna be grounded. Sweaty. It just wants to slide down my back. So weird. Sometimes I feel like my right side is stronger, or not as strong as my left, which is really kind of weird because I am right-handed. We got 10 seconds. All right. Challenge moves. Diamond push-ups. And then we're gonna do an alternating swing. That'll be 30 total. So do two arms. I'm going with my 40. We only have this and a finisher. Nice little 6 minute AMRAP. One, two, head in good alignment. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Alternating that swing now. Sending back from your bell. Hinging. One, two, three, four, five, six, eight. Squeeze the glutes. 9, 10, 20 more. 11. It's a lot. 13, 14, halfway there. Last 10. Last 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower it. Safely. Whew, and catch your breath. A little cardiovascular there. Whew. All right. Let your heart rate come down before you get to the finisher. So, whew, I'll just lean it as best as I can while I'm out of breath. 6 minute running clock. You're gonna do three exercises. It's 8 minutes. you're gonna do two push-up rows. So push-up row row, push-up row row for two. That's the first round. You're always gonna increase one rep for these three exercises every time you go through it, okay? But starting with two of those. Then three plank hops, and then four pullovers into a press. So I'm actually just gonna use two 25s for this whole thing, but the pullover, I'm just gonna use a 25 because that press, you only need one. So each round will increase. So then we'll go to three reps on the push-up row, four reps of the plank hops, five for the roll pullover press. And we'll just keep increasing. So follow my lead if you have a hard time following that. But I'm only gonna need my 25s. And it's a running clock. This is your last 8 minutes. I know it sounds long. You can do six if you want. Maybe I can let you know when we're on that 6 minute. I'll let you know. I'll try my best. One more sip of coffee. There we go. It's nonstop. Well, you can take breaks if you want. All right, we're gonna start 5 seconds with those two push-up. All of a sudden, I just got lighter in here. All right, 5 seconds. One push-up, row, row, push-up, row, row. At your own pace. Row, row, push-up, row, and row. Now we do three plank hops. One, two, three. All the way to the side. I'm gonna go down, doing four pullovers into a press. So pullover, one, two, I have four of these, okay. Three, last one. Then we're gonna go to three, four. Three push-ups into a plank row. And we're almost to minute in. So three of these. Push-up, row, and a row. So row on both arms. Not like a Manmaker where you do push-ups in it. A row each. This is three. So we're going to increase the rep. Now we're going to do four plank hops. One, two, three, four. Pull over for five with a press. So move my elevation. So down, pull over, come up, get my kind of a sit up and a press. We have two, three, four, last one, and we're almost 2 minutes in, and five. All right, now we're on to four push-ups, plank rows. We've got 6 minutes left. One. Two. Three. Last one. And we got five plank hops. So you know that the next exercise is always going to be extra rep. So this will be six. Rear pullover press. These are getting hard. I'm not gonna lie. It's that press part. I think my shoulders are just fried. One. Two. Three. I got two more. Five, one more. And six. All right, back to those push-up rows. Four, that was six, so five. my shoulders too. Give me a push up. This is four. I got one more. Four, I got three more. Oh, families, we got 3 minutes left. Two. 22 seconds if you want to do 6 minutes. This is my fifth one. I got one more. And there's 5 seconds left in that 6 minute. And 6 minutes is up. Four more. Then we got about a minute. We got 7 push-ups. Okay, we got 32 seconds. I imagine we'll finish with these. 1, 2, 15 seconds. 8 seconds. Oh, you are done. Oh, good job if you did the full 8. 6, still brutal, so congratulations on completing this. So, hope you enjoyed it. I feel like it went pretty quick. I think that AMRAP at the end didn't. So, please let me know what you think. Hope you enjoy the reboot from April. Have a good day. Drink lots of water, stretch, and get your vitamin D. And I'll see you next time. Bye.